Hi! In this video, I'm gonna present how to replace a battery connector to the XT60 and give you some soldering tips. Why XT60? Because it's an open standard, relatively small plugs can handle up to 60 amps of continuous current and it's very easy to solder. And another very important thing is that XT60 becomes more and more popular in the new chargers, so you can eliminate unnecessary adapters. Before we start soldering, we need to prepare a few things. What kind of soldering tip should I use? These two are too small and may lose heat too fast. The one to the left is better. It's thicker, so it can heat a larger surface, but its shape is not ideal for that kind of connectors. The last tip is the best one in this case. It is the type called C. Because it's the biggest one, it should heat a larger surface quicker and more efficiently. It also fits perfectly inside this rounded connector. This is the soldering station. Very simple but quite efficient. What temperature level should I use? It depends on the tin. I will use this kind of a tin as it already contains the flux and it's very easy to solder. It requires a soldering temperature between 340 and 420 degrees Celsius. So I will set it to 370-ish. If you use a thinner tip, you can heat up a soldering station a bit more. Let's say up to 400 degrees Celsius. And remember to not clean the solder tip with a sandpaper, but using the wet sponge or a special cleaner. The XT60 connectors are splitted in two parts, male and female. The female connector, the one on the right side, should be installed on the battery cables. The male connector should be installed on the ESC or charger wires. Before you start soldering, I suggest to connect both plugs together. It will increase a heat spreading surface, which can be a small disadvantage and force you to use a higher soldering temperature, but it will secure the pins in place in case you heat up the nylon chassis too much. And remember to use a fan or a mask when soldering. Safety first. Now, let's remove the old battery plug. Remember not to cut the both wires at the same time, as this will cause a short circuit and you could end up damaging the battery or blowing up or fire in the worst case. Cut off the first wire. It doesn't matter which one. You can also secure the other wire with electrical tape. Now, remove the 3 mm of the insulation and twist the wires. Place the tip of the soldering iron on the underside of the wire and start applying the tin. Make sure you are using tin with flux. Otherwise, apply flux to the wires before you start soldering. And try not to overheat the cable. Once it's done, remember to put the heat shrink tube on the cable. Now, place the connector in the clamps. It should be labeled plus and minus. If it's not, the rounded side of the plug is minus, black cable, and the square side is plus, red cable. Place the tip of the soldering iron on the connector's pin and heat it slightly. Apply the tin and dissolve it inside the joint. When tin is still melted, place the cable inside the pin and heat it to melt with the connector. Try not to heat the connector for too long, otherwise the nylon case may also melt. Wait a minute to apply the heat shrink tube or apply it at once, but do this very fast, because it will start to shrink immediately. Use a soldering tip, a lighter or a hot air to shrink the tube. Before doing the same with the second cable, I suggest you wait a minute or two for the cable and battery to cool down. Once you finish, make sure that you have soldered the cables with the proper polarity. Minus black cable to the rounded side and plus red cable to the square side. If you like the video, give the thumb up and subscribe. Cheers!